Telcos are actually the best placed, in my opinion, to take advantage of the cloud. Clearly because the cloud needs most of the assets that telcos have. So, for example, telcos have invested for many years in infrastructure, data centers throughout the world, clearly networks and sometimes global networks. Delivering services at a mass scale is what telcos do. And finally, customer reach. Telcos have, in Telefonica's case, we have 300 million customers around the world. So we already have all of the core assets needed to deliver cloud services, and we actually have reach into the customer base that we need to actually sell the cloud services. So we actually have a running start, put it that way. There are actually two kinds of challenges that we face. The first challenge is the external challenge, which is establishing Telefonica as a credible provider of IT services. And to address that, we're extending our current propositions and our current customer engagement with tangential cloud services. So when we have a conversation to a customer about mobile devices and selling them mobile packages, we're also talking now about what about the security of those devices? What about the backup of those devices? What about ensuring that you can collaborate with those devices? And cloud services are add-ons to that discussion. So that's how we're establishing the credibility. And the second point, of course, is to do with the internal challenges. So how do we line up all of the resources and how do we enable our salespeople to take a step up and start selling cloud services? The right cloud services are not challenging because, you know, the way that we focus our cloud services on is on the ones that we believe our customers need the most and the ones that are complementary to what we're currently selling. So they tend to be part of a package. So, for example, we would sell a package of devices and telecom services, mobile and data services, and also add-ons. So, for example, add-on cloud services for collaboration, security, backup, communication, and wrap it all into a package and give the customer, first of all, a really good proposition, and also, secondly, a very good price. So in that way, it's easy to monetize. I think if you're talking about monetizing a single cloud service, especially one that's delivered over the top, for example, McAfee by itself, will be more difficult. But wrapping it into an overall proposition makes it easier. I think there are a number of different ways. I think one area that's discussed is in carriers providing almost a wholesale network to cloud providers, and in that way you'd need to have APIs or a mechanism to give access to third parties to network resources. And the other area, as people realize that it's not one size fits all, and it's not just about the data center, and it's actually about the end-to-end, including the network. So quality of service and the ability to deliver different classes of service and different performance types across the network will become more and more important. So number one is creating APIs so that the network resources can be accessible by third parties. And second one is putting in more intelligence in the network to allow different qualities of service to be mapped to different kinds of cloud services. So yes, it's very important for Telefonica, and especially people who, in my sort of role, who are responsible for developing the next generation of services and looking where things are going, to first of all meet with the vendors to understand what the cutting edge technology developments are, but also to meet with peers at other telecom operators and understand where they're seeing success and how they're trying to monetize, and especially in the cloud arena. So open platform is a very important part of that process.